Today I am going to demonstrate you steps of opening of skull. We will start with the skull dissection. For that, incision is given from mastoid process to another mastoid process over the vertex. So I am giving the first incision. See, this is the mastoid process. So this is the mastoid process. I am starting my incision from one mastoid. It's going over the vertex toward the another mastoid. Okay, so this is the first incision. Please take care that hairs are not cut. So all the layers of the scalps are cut. This is the first incision. We'll just extend this incision little bit like this for ease of dissection. Now this anterior flap will be retracted forward. See, we are retracting the anterior flap. We should do a little bit blunt dissection with the finger because that gives better result compared to the knife. Like this. So anterior flap we are retracting forward. So take anterior flap till supraorbital margin, so like this. Now we will retract the posterior flap. Again, just extend the lesion just for ease of dissection. See, I am retracting the posterior flap. So see, now the anterior flap is anteriorly and posterior flap is. Now next step is identify the temporalis fascia. This is the temporalis fascia. Underlying is temporalis muscle. We will cut these temporalis muscles and fascia like this. By this swipe of knife, this temporalis fascia and temporalis muscle is cut. Similarly, on another side, we'll cut the temporalis muscles and the fascia. Okay. Now next part, we have to open the skull cap or the vault of the skull. For that, first we'll make an outline. We'll make an outline with the help of this iron blade. Thank you. We'll make an outline. Now our step was to open the skull cap. And first we had retracted the anterior flap forward and posterior flap backward. Then we had made an outline anteriorly above the supraorbital margin, posteriorly around the occipital protuberance. Then between the anterior and posterior cut, an angle is made. So we had made an outline to open the skull cap. Now we will use our chisel and hammer. So we have removed the skull cap. Now you can see the dura mater. We will remove the dura along the same line of incision that we have removed the skull cap. The same line of incision, we are removing the dura. It's a free flap of dura, the fold of dura. You can see the brain. This is the dura. Now we'll remove the brain. We'll just put our fingers of left hand in front of the frontal lobe. We can see the optic nerve. See the optic nerve. I'm going to cut this optic nerve. This optic nerve is cut on this one side and on another side. Below I can see the tentorium cerebelli. I'm cutting the tentorium cerebelli on one side. We'll cut the tentorium cerebelli of other side also. And simultaneously I will put my knife, the foramen magnum, to give a cut over the spinal cord. So this spinal cord is cut. Now with finger I will just try to remove. No, still tentorium cerebelli is intact. We have to give a cut over the tentorium cerebelli on this side. With the finger I am removing the cerebellum. Now for another loose side again, tentorium cerebelli is still intact. It has to be cut. Now with the finger I am removing the cerebellum of this side. Now cerebellum of both sides are in my hand. So final. So this is the brain. Complete brain. A complete brain with both cerebellum, with the pons, medulla. It's very soft. We'll put it in formalin, we'll fix it, then further after fixation we'll study it. Now we will open the abdomen and the chest cavity. For that incision is given
over the pubic symphysis, sparing the umbilicus till the sternal notch. We'll deepen this incision. You can see the layers of the abdomen, superficial fatty layer. This is a fat layer. I'm going to cut it. The rectus sheath. In the rectus sheath, there are rectus muscles. I'm going to cut all these structures. We'll reach, see, this is the rectus sheath. This rectus sheath below this fat. See, if we will cut this rectus sheath, you will see the muscles. See, now these muscles are there. You can see the muscles. We'll cut these muscles also. See, we are cutting the muscles also. And finally, we will reach to peritoneum. We'll reach till peritoneum. I have reached till peritoneum here. Now I am going to put my two fingers in the peritoneal cavity. Now a little smell will come because peritoneum has opened. So now this peritoneum is cut. So you can see the intestines. Okay, now I will remove the structures over the chest. So you can see these chest muscles, pectoralis major, latissimus dorsi on the side. We'll just lengthen this incision from here for easy dissection. Now same thing we will do for the other side. Another side. This I have done for the another side. Again we will just extend this incision from here for easy dissection. So now you can see the ribs, costal cartilage. We'll just identify some landmark. It's a clavicle, sternum, the sternoclavicular joint. I will just open this sternoclavicular joint from here. Joint seems to be little ossified as it's an adult, not adult, old age person, 82 year old. This side it is cut, opened. Okay. Now I'm going to cut the costal cartilage. See, these are costal cartilage. I'm going to cut costal cartilage on this side, now on this side. These costal cartilages are cut. Now we'll remove the, this is sternal plate. This is called sternal plate because it bears costal cartilage also. Now we'll remove this sternopericardial structures. This attachment between the sternum and the pericardium. This sternal along with costal cartilage, that is sternal plate, is removed. Now the chest cavity, we can see the lungs. lungs are adherent. See the adhesions of the lungs. See, these are called adhesions of the lung. These are because of pleural inflammation, pleurisy. Even pleural fluid, you can see. There is pleural effusion is there in this case. Pleural effusion. We'll first open the pericardial cavity. This is pericardium. We'll open the pericardium cavity. We'll look for the heart. So there is very much fluid is there. Amount of pericardial fluid is, it's more than normal. Even in the brain, we could see more fluid in this case. So there is some pathology is there. We'll study the pathology. And we can, heart is enlarged. Heart is enlarged. So this is the inferior vena cava. I'm going to open the inferior vena cava. Cut the inferior vena cava. The blood will come and we'll cut it. The clotted blood clot, the postmortem clot. Then on the above it is superior vena cava. So heart is enough. Heart is large in size. It has patch also. This white patch is also there, fibrotic patch. Maybe some old MI. Okay. Most of the lung is adherent. See the adhesion. Lung is adherent. I will try to remove liver first. Let's first remove the liver. The other side also. So liver. Okay. Gallbladder will also be there on this side. Gallbladder. Now we'll for kidneys. This is the intestine, you can see. This is the greater omentum. Okay. Greater omentum is attached to the greater curvature of the stomach. So this is the stomach. Stomach seems empty, but we'll just open the stomach. We'll see the interior of the stomach. It's not empty. It has some contents. Liquefied contents are there. You can see the stomach, internal mucosa. See kidneys. I'm just giving incision in the retroperitoneal area and trying to find out the kidneys. So these kidneys are there. So you can see the kidney, some cyst over the surface of the kidney. The multiple small cysts are also there on the surface. ऐसे पकड़ो नीचे ना, सो किडनीज यू कैन सी द सिस्ट, इवन मल्टीपल स्मॉल सिस्ट्स आर ऑल्सो देयर ऑन द सरफेस. ओके, विल गो फॉर द किडनी ऑफ अदर साइड. Go for the kidney on the other side. So this is the kidney on the other side. You can see this is the kidney on the other side.
Tissue sister.
Again, small cysts are there on the surface also. Okay. Now, I'll just show you some anatomical structures. This is the small intestines, the mesentery. We can even cut this mesentery. We can just cut and I can show you. Just keep on pulling it on one side. You can see how long this small intestines and mesentery. Okay, so this whole thing, this is just I'm showing you this small intestines and mesentery. On this side I will show you the cecum. So this is large intestines. You can see this, these are called tinea coli on the surface. This longitudinal band of muscle is called tinea coli. And you can see the haustrations, in the large intestines, which are not there in the small intestines. And below you can see this muscles, psoas muscles. The muscles are there, psoas muscles you can see. So we'll close it from here.